this video, I'm showing you how to make this vocoder by Daft Punk and Ableton. My name is Matt Lang. Let's get started.
What a fancy intro that was. Let me know in the comment section what you thought about it. So to make this vocoder in Ableton, you need two different things. We need a synthesizer and then a vocoder on the audio source. Let's first take a look at the synthesizer. I made this an operator. If you don't feel like copying everything I say in this video, you can go to my website, which is linked in the description, and there you can download everything for free and start making music with this vocoder immediately. So to make this synthesizer, you need a very basic operator patch. We have two oscillators. One is set at the normal level. We have a saw wave D selected. For the envelope, nothing special is going on. We have a very slow release, 2 milliseconds. We have no attack and just a normal sustain. Then where the magic happens is in the global section here. We have time set to 100%, tone to 73, and the volume is at default. But then what we do is we set the voices to 1 and enable glide in the pitch envelope section, right here. Then by experimenting with the glide time, we can make things smoother or less smooth. Then finally, we add a second oscillator with a sine wave. This is the default envelope, and we set the coarse to 2 and the level to around minus 30. What we get then is a little bit of FM going on, as you can see by this pattern. And this makes the sound just that tiny bit more interesting. Don't forget to mute the synthesizer track, or otherwise it will play over your audio from the mic. Let's take a listen to the synthesizer first. And now let's take a look at the vocoder. We have it on the audio track right here, in which I recorded my vocals. Let's take a listen first.
Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger, more than ever, rubber after rubber, work is never over.
You'll have the same sound in just 2 minutes. So I'm gonna grab a new vocoder here to show you how to make it. This is the default preset. The first thing you wanna do is set the carrier to external and change the audio to input from operator. So basically the synthesizer we just made. What we then want to do is set the sensitivity to 100% and change the unvoiced to about minus 40 dB. What this is gonna do is make some of the S and F sounds that we make also be heard. That way it will make it easier to understand what you're saying. The next thing you wanna do is set the bands to 40 to add more clarity and more detail to it. Change the range to somewhere around 140 all the way to 18K. We are going to turn the bandwidth down to around 87% and set the gate to around minus 50. Then finally, we want to set this to mono because we have a mono source. Turn down the depth a little bit to around minus 75, 77, something like that. Next up is the attack and release. We are going to set the attack to around 6 milliseconds to eliminate any clicks and weird pops. And then set the release all the way to 13 milliseconds, which is really quick, and it is going to help us to make this a very accurate vocoder. Then finally, we want to turn up the formants just a tiny bit to around 4.5, but this can change depending on the sound of your own voice. This is to make you sound a little bit more robotic. So that is the basic vocoder preset. If you want the identical settings that I used in the demo, you can simply go to my website and download this entire effect chain as a package, and it's completely free as well. So this is what we have right now.
Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger, more than ever, rubber after rubber, work is never over.
I want to make it a little bit more interesting. So first I added some EQ 8. This is going to change depending on your voice and recording. And then I added some glue compressor. Nothing special going on here. But what you can also add is the hybrid reverb. This will also be included if you download this from my website. We have the hybrid reverb set to algorithmic, and the algorithm is dark hall. Then we changed the pre-delay, decay, size, damping, shape, and bass. And I have the dry wet at around 20% to make it a really subtle reverb. You can copy these settings if you want. I didn't change anything about the EQ, I think. And that is how we get this final vocoder sound. Let's take a final listen.
Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger, more than ever, rubber after rubber, rock is never over.
That's it for this video. If you want to learn how to make this bass sound, in Serum, you can click on the pop-up banner on your screen to watch that video. And if you want to see more videos by me, consider subscribing. I make videos about free plugins, making music, tips and tricks, tutorials, and more. If you want to support the video or if you enjoyed this tutorial, make sure to leave a like and a comment to let me know. And share this with your friends so they can have a cool vocoder in their arsenal too. Thank you guys for watching. See you next time. My name is Matt Flank. Peace out.